Now, an update on Hurricane Hector. Of course, we've been tracking this system since for over a week now. Still a Category 4 hurricane as it approaches the state. We're so lucky this morning to be joined by John Bravender. He's live from the Central Pacific Hurricane Center this morning for the latest on the hurricane. Good morning, John.
Morning, Kelly.
Thanks so much for joining us. Okay, we'd like just a breakdown of Hector. What's the latest information on the system right now?
Right. Hector is still a Category 4 hurricane. It weakened a bit overnight, but the good news is it's continued tracking westward. It still looks like it's on track to pass south of the state. And the other good news is it's also a relatively small-sized hurricane with a limited extent of impacts from it.
Okay, good. Small but powerful. Forecast to pass to our south as a Category 2. Sure. So still scary, especially when you see the satellite image of this system so close to us. So what impacts are we expecting? The good news is it's passing well to the south, but what does that mean for us in the islands?
The first impact we'll see would be high surf. We have a high surf warning out for east-facing shores of the Big Island, 10 to 15-foot surf. That will be building through the day, peaking tonight Wednesday. The other impact is that there's still potential for tropical storm force winds. Those chances have been dropping as it's continuing to pass south, but there's still a 1 in 5 chance for areas like South Point to see tropical storm force winds.
Okay, and tropical storm force winds, anything of 39 miles an hour and above. So still fairly significant. But as of right now, yeah, if it stays on the track that it's at, what are the wind speeds we're most likely looking at?
What we're most likely to see is it would be essentially like a strong trade wind day. With that as well, for Hawaii County, rainfall, especially windward sections, you could see some heavy showers, but not more than you would normally expect through a pretty wet trade wind pattern.
Okay, wonderful. And as for the timing of the rainfall, what are we looking at?
That would be mainly a Wednesday type event, maybe picking up late tonight and continuing through the day on Wednesday.
Okay, and again, we're looking right now at a satellite image of this system as it approaches us. Still a little bit eerie as we see such a powerful storm so close by, but are we completely in the clear?
No, this is one thing you do need to pay attention to it. It's looking much, much more likely that it'll be passing south of the state. Mm-hmm. But there are other impacts that you could see away from it as well. Even though we wouldn't necessarily be in the radius of winds directly from it, there's a lot of interaction with island terrain and the wind pattern over us. We could see some enhancement and some strong gusty winds anywhere across the state.
Right. And even the slightest deviation to the north of this track could definitely mean very big different impacts in terms of stronger wind speeds than, of course, for Hawaii Island, even the potential, once again, for those tropical storm force winds. All right. Now, John, a lot of people wondering and a little bit worried. You know, you see a big system passing to our south. People think back to Iniki or other systems that have come up from the south. Is that forecast to happen? And if not, why not?
Oh, no, we're not expecting a sudden recurve with this like happened during Iniki back in 92. Large-scale pattern is driving it westward. With the ridge over the islands steering it away, we'll keep it south of the state with some shift northward possible, but there's no, for example, upper-level trough or southerly winds over us that would cause it to recurve northward and directly across the state like Iniki did.
Okay, wonderful. Again, thank you so much, John Bravender, for joining us. Hoping for just a typical trade wind day in the coming days, but we'll continue to closely monitor this. Again, any big changes, we'll, of course, be in contact with the Central Pacific Hurricane Center and then give you guys at home the latest. All right, thanks so much, John, for joining us.